places are like little bad pennies. You recognize them. You know their name. They deserve a fresh start too, as we begin this voyage together. Everything that I have seen this transformation team talk about, their plans, their goals, what I've heard your superintendent say, what I've heard your principal, Ms. Gray, say, everything that they've told you and that they've told us as your achievement services team has been to keep us on our pedagogical toes. They want us on the cutting edge. They want us on our toes. But for this frame and this moment, I don't know that your toes are the best visual picture. You may want to think about your knees. We're going to accomplish this. We've got to remain humble, and we've got to remain forgiving, because these people around the table are not perfect. This person standing here is not, no one's expecting perfection out of you. We're expecting your best, though. I'm hoping that you can depend on me for my best. So let's keep that in mind. So right now, right this very moment, if you're sitting in here and someone on this staff has sent you up, let you down, picked on you, didn't give you credit due, if you are carrying any of those harmful things, then on their behalf right now, I'm going to ask you to forgive them. Because you see, we can't move forward and sail like a clip. And I know a history teacher will catch Friday on that. You can't sail like a clip if you're dragging past your weight tonight. So I encourage you to let that go so that you can meet your goals. I read this on a marquee once, and oh, I think it's so true. To hold a grudge in your head is giving somebody else rent, free rent,